Hello? Is anyone still here?
Hey, doggy.
Hello? Is anyone here still? Hello?
I guess no one's here.
Oh, a computer. Yes. Okay, here we go. Let's record a transmission. Let's get help over here real soon.
Godzilla vs. King Kong, the movie that everybody has been waiting for a long time, and it is finally here. Oh man, and I must say, after watching it just this weekend, it's a blast to watch. The clash between these two titans delivers an amazing blow for the audience to sit back and not to overthink things at all. Everything from the start to the finish was an enjoyable roller coaster ride, and it had such an amazing build up to the epic climax between these two giants. So basically, the conflict of the movie is basically about Godzilla once again rampaging on Earth due to being provoked by an unconfirmed source that's causing him to be provoked and cause wreckage again. So the humans team up with King Kong, as who they're holding him as hostage or that from studying, and they travel down to the hollow Earth to find some type of power source to stop Godzilla. But of course things go awry and the humans unleash another problem that is a bigger threat than Kong and Godzilla themselves. So first of all, I didn't get the chance to see the last Godzilla movie, so I don't really know anything about that other than I heard about the negative reviews, but I might check it out sometime, you never know. Okay, so first and foremost, the one thing that stood out to me was the breathtaking visuals. I really loved the visual effects that they managed to create. I loved how the animators gave a lot of attention to detail on every object that they created, especially with the effects when they were down in the hollow Earth. That's probably my favorite part of the whole film, the design of that. Like, the animators really went all out on that. It makes you feel so grand, it's just so breathtaking to look at. It just gives you the time to sit back and just gaze in awe. And the designs for the creatures along with the inanimate objects were probably one of my favorite parts of the film too. Another pro was how they gave little to more depth by adding a backstory between Kong and Godzilla and why they have a feud in the first place, which is a clever way of creating the story's conflict. And they explain why they hate each other and how they can defeat each other with one single power source. And the action sequences were wonderful to watch as well. Every fight scene, like even the cinematography for the fighting scenes felt so grand, like this epic climatic fight just feels like you're really there. It feels so realistic, unlike the old Godzilla or King Kong movies that just had like a guys in suits fighting over a soundstage. But this one, everything just felt like it was really there, like it's just a really big gigantic fight between these two big monsters, and it feels like the city just feels so real. And I gotta say, whoever this Adam Wingard is, he's got a future with Hollywood, just say. I know the one thing that people were complaining about was the human characters, and I gotta say, I disagree with that. I thought they were pretty helpful and they were pretty useful in this film. Sure, there were at times they took over the spotlight too much, but no, they didn't really get in the way of Godzilla and Kong at all. And to some capacity, there's one human character with that little girl who was deaf and used sign language to communicate with Kong, and it turns out that King Kong can actually speak sign language because of her, which I thought, but that was a unique writing skill that we've never seen before with Kong himself. I absolutely adored that little girl. I think she was the smartest character throughout this whole film, and she knew, she felt the heart, she knew she was basically Kong's mentor guideline, someone who understood his pain and was basically his guardian angel. And I thought that was a really good touch throughout this whole film. For Godzilla's side of the characters, I know they're from the last movie, I haven't seen them. Like, Millie Bobby Brown really is great, along with the black guy who was the conspiracy theorist. Sure, they didn't really do much, and that was okay, because at the end of the day, we don't come for these deep, complex human characters. We came here for basically a boxing match. I think my one complaint for this movie has to be the story. I felt the story was quite underwhelming and didn't really feel fatigue or anything interesting, but that's just my part. I liked what it got, but I just felt it was a little bit inconsistent, though I won't really go that much into detail. So overall, I'm pretty proud of what we got. Yes, I know we already have those older Japanese King Kong versus Godzilla films, but now we have a modern take on it, and we have a modern film that future generations would hopefully talk about this for some time. And I just hope we get a sequel to this. If not, then I understand, but I have a feeling there's probably going to be a sequel to this. Maybe a few years from now. But we'll see. So overall, like I said, this is a very great popcorn movie and you should go watch it.
Boom! There you go. Transmission sent. Alright. Let's hope the U.S. Army or the military can come here as soon as possible. Oh my god. What was that? Oh god, don't tell me they're already here. Is that them?
Where are they? I don't see them. Oh shit.
Oh my god!